almost a year ago. And we have been talking pretty much nonstop about having her come and speak. And I was asking, and she was saying yes, and I was asking, and then she would say yes, and I was asking. We just never sat down and came up with a time until now. She is, without a doubt, one of the most remarkable women that I've met. And you need to hear her story. And in large part, it's not only because of what she's gone through or where she's been, because we've had, as you know, a number of people who have gone through some very difficult times. Derek went through two, not one, but two bone marrow transplants and beat the odds. It was, what, 10% the second time? Much until you give the 10% to God.
Yeah.
And then God can do a lot with 10%. So we've had Derek, we've had Michael, we've had others that have seen the power of God working in their lives. And Samantha brings that story as well. She has had some real ups and some difficult times, but I can't imagine that she's ever been down, only because of what I've seen of her. I'm sure she has been, but she...
Not often.
This smile is always there. It's always there. So, there you go. I thought it was her sister.
Oh, yeah.
There you go.
We have lots of those, too.
So, because I have a really big mouth, I'm going to give the microphone to Samantha and let her talk. Make sure you can keep it up by you. You want this to lean on? I teach pastors how to preach sometimes, and I tell them, if you feel like you're going to get faint, lean on the pulpit.
Oh, you're not
going to. So, first of all, maybe tell them a little bit about, because you're now a college graduate, where you went to school, what your degree is in, and what your plans were for that degree.
So I attended IUPUI downtown, and I got my degree in kinesiology, which is exercise science, and now I'm using that being a wellness coach here at the YMCA. So on the floor, I'm able to help members reach their goals, learn how to use the equipment, and things like that.
So what were your plans initially? Because I think they've probably changed over the last
year. When did you graduate?
I graduated in May of 2016, and I went to on vacation to Colorado to... I went on vacation in Colorado to celebrate graduating college, and I was going to look at some master's programs out there to get my degree, my master's degree in occupational therapy. And then I was mountain biking in the Rocky Mountains in Colorado and flipped over my handlebars on the bike. And I hit my face on the concrete, causing my brain to shake in my head, resulting in a traumatic brain injury. And I originally spent 30 days in Boulder Community Hospital in their ICU, and then a hospital bed opened up at one of the world-renowned brain injury hospital rehabilitations in the country in Denver, Colorado, 30 miles away from where I was, Craig Rehabilitation Hospital. And while I stayed there, therapy was Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. till 5 p.m. every day, and I wouldn't be where I am today, standing here,
yes,
talking to you all to share this story if it wasn't for that hospital.
Now, before you got that far, though, when you were after the accident, that could have been treacherous out in the mountains with nobody around, but you had some special provisions from God.
Yes.
Tell them about that.
So the Rocky Mountain Rescue Team trains one day a year, and they were training that day luckily for me, when I flipped over the handlebars, they were only a quarter mile away to come save me.
Because it would have taken about another hour and 15 minutes for any EMT or any helicopter or anyone to get to where she was. And the Rocky Mountain Rescue Team had a doctor, an EMT, all the fire and rescue, like that's what they train for, is to rescue people who fall in the mountains or get hurt in the mountains. And one day a year. So if that's not God being in the right place at the right time, that it would have been an extra hour and a half that her brain would have suffered, and they got her wrapped up, ready, into an actual truck that took her to the top of the mountain where she was airlifted out to the, sorry, I get teary-eyed on that one. I mean, that was an absolute, that was the first miracle of anything.
How did he know?
Sorry, go ahead.
The person I was with looked back, and when he looked back, I was on the ground having a couple seizures. And so he was able to call 911, and they were luckily a quarter mile ahead of me.
Yeah.
And another way I know that God was very present during this situation was that I used to live on the Monon, and I would ride a bike for like 20 to 40 miles at a time. And I'm like 1 mile into this trail, and I fall off, and I'm in an area where the most world-renowned brain injury hospital is. So I was there for a reason.
Yes.
Absolutely. Now, how long were you hospitalized?
101 days.
And then when did you get transferred back here?
December 21st, 2016.
Good.
10 days before my 24th birthday.
Mm.
And right before Christmas.
Yeah, let's not forget Christmas.
And my goal was to be able to walk out of the hospital, and I was able to. I walked off the plane and had a bunch of people taking pictures of me at the airport. It was amazing.
So what, tell us about your recovery. Easy, hard?
Very hard. I get better every day. My recovery is still happening.
I saw pictures of you in the pool, swimming. Was that part of your recovery, or?
Yes. Therapy in the hospital. They have physical therapy, aqua therapy in the water. So I was in a sit-down lift. I was lifted into the pool, and I was able to even swim and move my arms. And my arms did not move at that point out of the water. Eat, use the restroom. I had to relearn how to be a human completely again.
So what, maybe tell them what you're doing here at the Y with your kinesiology degree. I mean, that's, you know, the Y is very, very good, but we don't have a lot of people with kinesiology degrees. So can you tell them what you're doing?
So I'm able to use what I learned when I have members with wellness appointments come to me with their goals, then I'm able to give them some recommendations on how many days they should be at the gym and what they should be working on in the gym and what muscles to work and how to use the machines.
And it's probably very helpful for them now. So
okay,
now you're
much.
On the other end of the in helping.
And I'm very happy to be.
Well, I know that I'm going to introduce you to my son later, who also had a head injury a few years ago. Probably ought to meet my wife as well. Her sister, her sister has a degree in kinesiology, a PhD though, and teaches at UConn, but for the longest time worked with US Swim in Colorado Springs, and she biked probably some of the same trails that you were on. Yeah. So, obviously this isn't where you thought your life would be at this point.
Definitely not.
Where did you think it would be, and how does this compare to where those dreams were?
I thought I'd be living in Colorado getting my master's degree.
And how does this compare to
it? Well, this is completely not what I had in mind at all, but it's also still very fulfilling because it's taught me a lot about myself and about the world and all the things I needed to learn personally. Instead of getting a master's degree, I was able to get a master's degree in life.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And all of that comes into play in probably ways that you never would have gotten to had it not been for this accident.
Most definitely.
Right? Yeah. Not bad lessons to learn, and I think that, unfortunately, most of the time, God needs to get our attention somehow in very difficult ways, but even as Psalm 23 says, you know, that I will be with you even through the darkest valleys of even death. I will be with you always.
Yeah, I am not alone.
Absolutely. Absolutely. We've got a couple things that we want to, do you have anything more you want to tell them?
Yeah, I was going to ask if anybody had any questions they would like to ask me if I missed anything.
Samantha, God has definitely worked in your life and what? How did he work to bring you to the why? How did you end up here?
Good question.
Well, I was set up with a job coach through Easter Seals Crossroads.
Okay.
And I started off as a volunteer here. And they had an opening in the Wellness Center for a wellness coach, and I applied for that position.
Okay, so, fantastic.
The Easter Seals and there's also a program called Vocational Rehab Services, and they help you train. They put you back in physical therapy. They pay for job-specific training. They put her through a driving program. Driving therapy is what they called it, and she did about 8 weeks, and now she has her driver's license. They adapted. The steering wheel has a spinner knob, and then the turn signal comes to the right because her lefty kind of gives her a little bit of trouble because her bleed is in the right basal ganglion, so it affected the left motor skills. She has what's called, her actual diagnosis is a diffuse axonal traumatic brain injury, so she has a bleed. But she also has a lot of little bleeds, some on the right, some on the left, that just block certain neurons from firing, emotion. I mean, a lot. Your brain, let me tell you, your brain, I've never learned so much about it, but it's the craziest thing. The things that it affects, like emotion, thinking, processing. I mean, she's had to relearn everything. About that as well, not just physical, a lot of things.
And I think sometimes we always assume that the brain is kind of permanent. Once it's set,
yeah.
It's set, and
no.
With brain injuries, you can't recover, but it's amazing how even if portions of the brain die off,
yeah.
The functions will switch to the underused portion, because you're only, and I don't want to shock any of you, but you're only using a small portion of your brain.
Yeah.
And that's nothing personal.
You only use 10% of your brain.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's got a lot of, God has built a lot of redundancy into there.
So, places. Where some of the diffuse bleeds are, those affect, like I said, emotion and all that. Now through neuroplasticity, which is retraining your brain, that those come back eventually. They never give you a diagnosis to say, oh, you're gonna be this in 4 years, or you're gonna do this. It's what you make it, it's how you adapt and overcome to your new normal, just as you said, this church is your new normal.
Absolutely.
This is her new normal, and our whole family. I have 4 other children who this has affected as well, and my husband. Or I have 3 other children, sorry. Yeah, so.
You have to forgive her, she has a brain injury.
Yeah, trust me, sometimes I think I do. Yeah, so she's, I mean, the effects that it's had are not negative. They're all been positive. Everyone in our family has grown and just adapt and overcome all of your trials and tribulations is what we have learned that you have to do, because now we do have.
And most of us don't grow or choose to unless we're forced to.
Exactly.
And, you know, to say, well, I never want any trials to come along would make your life very static.
Yes.
You know, as unpleasant as there are, I think back on my own life and I think, wow, there's some things I would never want anybody else to have to go through.
That's right.
But boy, I'm glad I did.
Well, yeah.
You know, I'm glad I went through it, because now I am who I am. Samantha is who she is because of those trials.
I remember in the hospital, I would say, God, I will trade her places. Please let me be her. You know, like where I was pleading, I pleaded with them. I said, this can't happen to her, it shouldn't. And now I know that pleading, you don't plead with God. You don't have to. You don't have to do that.
He's got you.
Yes, he has you all the time.
Brothers and sisters, how many of each? Father, we thank you for Samantha, for her witness, for her love, for her bright smile. We thank you even for the adversities and for the trials that come all of our ways. And we pray that this day, as you have in all days, that you will walk beside her, that you will keep her always on your path, that you will see her through even the valleys of the shadow of death, whether it's little deaths or big ones. And help her, Lord, to become your woman, there ready to share your gospel and the good news of her life through the life of your Son. In Christ's name, amen. Now, we've got something for you. Nothing really big, so don't get real excited. We have some water bags, and my wife thought, because you're an athlete, you need to have that. So that's a little. And to light your path, we have a flashlight, only it's one that has a magnet, so you can set it somewhere as you're doing some work. And just don't shine this in your light, in your face, it will blind you. So, and then this is my favorite. Several years ago, we gave everyone one of these little medallions, and you can find something that, to string it to. It's called a Sankofa. It's a Ghanaian symbol, and it represents the Sankofa bird is actually reaching back and taking an egg in its mouth. And what it stands for is taking what we need from the past so that we can move forward into the future. And I thought, that's you. You need to have that, because you have done that.
Most definitely.
So,
what is it again?
Sankofa. And I will send that to you by email.
Okay.
So, good. Well, thank you. And I'll let you have a seat.